Honoring James Steele upon the 50th anniversary of the publication of his novel, River of Earth, whereas James Steele of Little Car Creek, Kentucky, is known as leading Appalachian literary figure, and whereas James Steele, a native of Alabama, came to Hyndman, Kentucky in 1932 as a librarian of the Hyndman Settlement School, and whereas James Steele was known as the Footmobile, traveling throughout Knott County, delivering books to people, and whereas James Steele formerly taught at Morehead State University, and whereas James Steele published his novel, River of Earth, in February 1940 and reprinted it in 1977. And whereas the Camden Carroll Library at Morehead State University will host the 50th anniversary celebration in honor of James Steele, Monday, February 5th, 1990, to be held in the James Steele Room, 5th floor of the Library Tower, from 2 to 4 p.m. Be resolved by the House of Representatives of the General Assembly of the Commonwealth of Kentucky that this honorable body salutes James Steele, the leading Appalachian literary figure, for his creative works, and congratulates him upon the 50th anniversary of the publication of his novel, River of Earth. That when the House of Representatives adjourns this day, February 2nd, 1990, it does so honor of James Steele. That the clerk of the House is ordered to transmit a copy of this resolution to Mr. James Steele, Little Car Creek, Kentucky, 41822. And I want to take this copy and deliver it to you personally.
Thank you.
I won't go into reading, I'll let you, it's pretty much the same thing, but it's also something civil.
Thank you.
Fine.
Fine.
Congratulations, I've got to run
Thanks.
And try to pass a few more laps.
Thank you,
appreciate
Thank
it.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming.
I think
I'm
officially getting underway now.
Just sit down here.
Anytime.
I mean, I can bring copies of the bookstore has outside. If that's satisfactory with you,
yes, right.
Unless you'd rather.
No, I'll sit down.
Right.
Fine.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. These are all things for me. I did kick my dentist when I left here, and I come for 6 months anyway. I'm always glad to come. It's always a fun trip, all coming down into Round County. It was a great experience being here.
Is it? Do you get some inspiration, or what is it like working with the students, that age group, when they're so full of promise, looking to their futures?
Well, I miss them a lot. And after I left, that was the thing I did miss. I was sort of glad after all those years. I was a sort of a burnout case, actually. It was time to go home and write a few more books, which I did. As you know, when you're working in classrooms, you might have the time, but you never. The edge is gone. You use it. I see too many people. And
do you need to be on your own? Do you need to be on your own in order to get the inspiration to write?
Well, I don't know about inspirations. That's a beautiful word. I'll leave that in the dictionary. Anyway, I have people need to. I want to. Mm-hmm. I just want to do it.
Well, I brought up inspiration. You don't. Do you think that's part of what you have to have in order to be able to write, or is that just you're saying it's a pretty word? Where do the words come from? The ideas come from?
I really don't know.
I'm only creating trouble.
Anyway, I miss the world, as you must know. Travel around lately in recent years, anyway. But though I don't have anything to do with it, I've been writing since I was a child. Something or other. There's his stories.
What is it that got you going on writing? What is it that...
I don't even remember beginning.
Uh-huh.
I don't remember beginning. I was writing. I wrote a short story when I was 9. I remember. Still have it. And I could have looked when I saw that. I read it after all these many years. After all, I'm 83 and a half at this moment. I read it many years ago, and it still exists. And I could have known then, looking back at this, that I was fated to write some more.
Uh-huh. I know you've written some children's books, and many of your books are through a child's perspective. What is it about looking at the world through a child's perspective that makes you want to write in that way?
Well, not all the books are that way.
Mm-hmm.
Not all the stories are that way at all.
But I mean, you've written some books for children.
Birth itself is from the point of view of a child, through a child's eyes. But remember you as a child. And this book has been said 50 years old today. And that was a very notable day in my life, besides the book itself.
Tell me about that.
I went over to Jackson, Kentucky, and I was going to Winchester to catch the train south. It was a very cold morning, and the train was late from Hazard. And I was standing by the stove warming, and when a deputy sheriff came in, and in a few moments, somebody ran in and said, they need you across the street. So he walked one over, and I followed him, and he was shot dead in my face. And that bothered me, naturally. And then the train came. I got on the train, and I had in my hand a review of this book in Time magazine, River of Earth, which was a very fine review, indeed, called the Warren Barr. But I wrote a letter at the time. You never write a letter, you don't expect to be reprinted. 2 weeks later, it was in the Time magazine letter section, followed by a report of this incident. And they put the word, I don't know what you could, they added the title, Bloody Breath. I didn't do that, you know.
And that was the title of the letter.
I'm always working on something rather than one thing the next, several things.
Anything in particular to mention?
Well, I've always, I'm not exactly superstitious, but I don't take chances. Somehow it's psychologically bad. I think discuss something you haven't done, so I never talk about it.
So you have to wait and see it published?
No, I have to wait too. Until I do it.
Well, one last question. You're so well known as an Appalachian writer, Appalachian poet. What is it that sets Appalachia apart from other regions?
This is where I live. I live here. I know more about this than anything else.
But are the people are the people different?
I think Appalachia, my East Kentucky, is for me the most interesting place in the world to live. And I've traveled 26 countries, but I always come back, and I have a lot of quarrels with it, you know, for that matter, a lot of things I don't like. But on the whole, there's something about everybody, somebody in Appalachia. In the cities, you get lost, you get homogenized, you lose your identity, I think. But up there, no matter, for better or worse, and it's a sort of a classless society, everybody is just as good as anybody else. And that's what you think about it, you know? And that makes a difference. Thank you.
Can you stay just for 1 minute, and Lewis, the photographer, will get a two-shot, what we call a two-shot of us chatting back and forth, and let you get to what you need to do.
Yeah, you can prune that.
I prune it. That's a good way of putting it. What we do is we call it. Yeah, yes.
And if you're supposed to be
Some of the terrorists, you know. We did stay out of
big city as much as possible and going to a meeting. Yeah, I went to Cuba this last year. I told all the propaganda comes over the TV where I was going.
You mean that?
Yeah. Training for children, marketing training.
So you work and taught your poems last semester, and I wanted to let you know the students just love it. They just
first,
it.
You know. 60. Yeah, I'll do a poem here. A long time.
I know when I met Dr. Thomas, I was asking around for people who knew James Still, knew of him, and I ran into Dr. Thomas, M.K. Thomas, and he said,
yeah.
Oh, yes, I'm a friend.
Yeah, he's in the basement. Yeah. I reckon here, I lived several years ago, I know a serious operation, it was, turned out to be very serious, and he came and stayed all day, every day, with me, until I was out of danger. And wasn't that something?
Yeah.
Yeah. He just sat there and never said a word. But I couldn't talk to him. Is it what name you want here?
George.
For George, your last name?
My last name is Eklund. E-K.
Right. Just a minute. E-K.
L-U-N-D.
Yes, yes, yeah. What I consider my really great triumph. My name is in the dictionary, Webster's in the big dictionary.
There you go.
Yeah.
You've arrived.
Anyway, I don't have to do anything yet, you know. Well, there was a word that I rescued from. It was already around about 15th century, so I don't know. Anyway, I rescued for writing, so they quoted me. And I tell that, you know, I don't have the slightest hesitation to tell me. I thought somebody said, oh, I was awful shy and all like that. Said I hadn't talked to him 5 minutes, and he told me he didn't have a much for anybody. And I don't. Is this for you too?
Yes,
for George?
Yes.
I'm just going to put this for George.
That's fine.
Students could find a better place. However, I couldn't write here because my time, my energy was all taken up with students and meetings and the things you have to do if
That's
you're
right.
teaching in a school. I'm not complaining, but I'm just saying I couldn't.
It's tough.
Yeah, glad to meet you.
It's a real honor.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Good luck.
Come over here. I want you to introduce you. This fellow wanted to meet you. He knows Rhonda. He's a friend of Rhonda's. And that's
her. Hey, her help.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what they tell me.
Also, now
that
you care.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it is now? What about oral since you had no oral yet?
Struggle was to please that, and I think she's talked about
Well, she ought to after all that.
But she's got all this research. She's got all that. She's got an awful lot of it already written. Mm-hmm. Just be a matter of compiling.
You never come up there. You never come around.
Well, I'm done doing that.
Oh, oh, you are. You do that. Other side of the world. Yeah, I've been over there. Used to take books off that punch in school.
Do you remember?
The bookmobile, I was the first one.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Do you remember my grandfather, John Harrison Mullins?
I don't particularly know, but that's a long time ago.
Well, my dad went to that school. They used to go to Mushroom School.
Oh, they did?
Yeah.
Is that what they called?
In the Punchin area.
Yeah, you want me to sign this for you?
Yeah, I appreciate it. I know, well, I'm related to Teresa.
Who are you?
Yeah. My mother's furry.
Yeah. See? You look like a lot of furries.
Thanks a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And I work here in this department, and I've been looking forward to
seeing you. In this apartment here?
Yes.
I've been up here another time.
Somehow I missed you every time. And then, of course, when you received the Treasure Award, you had people with you and things, and so I didn't. Mm-hmm.
Yours, the name is what now in here?
Alma.
L-E-L-M-A.
A-L-M-A.
Yeah.
Fairchild.
Yeah, I can spell it. Thank you.
Joyce,
sit down.
The master could not be here today. She wanted to give you her regards.
Well, thank you.
She
who are you?
Which needle on sociology.
Oh, yeah. Oh, of course I know you. Well, yeah, right.
Your,
sorry.
I mentioned
it's been some time.
Have you mm-hmm. been doing okay?
Huh?
Oh, good. What I have today, I'm going to give it to you. I have a copy.
Oh.
I'll present that to you.
Okay.
We have a copy of the tape where you discussed the genesis of the River Firth, and it was Joyce LeMaster and myself that interviewed you, and so
right.
That's your copy. We thought this would be a good day to hand it to you.
Well, thank you. Appreciate it.
And you can see yourself on
mm-hmm.
there.
Good.
Okay, and she had to be out of town, or she would know that.
All right. It's hard to see. Give my best wishes.
So let us know if you have any comments.
Thank you.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So long since I've been here.
I'll tell you my legs notes.
Uh-huh.
That's your
horse. You know, go around a lot, and that packed out my headlights and stuff. And of course, it takes a lot of walking. You don't have to see the ruins, and nobody can drive.
Well, they do drive, I understand. It's dangerous. Stop a lot of traffic there,
basically. I thought it makes the machine look worse.
Here's this address about a mile. Yes, ma'am. You can let us post it.
Fearful.
Well, we would appreciate it.
Down. I was afraid to come. They just catch hold and pull me in. I wouldn't have to go.
I still would like to go there.
Don't die before you get swallowed so you don't go to the rest of the world.
When I was young,
I couldn't go when I was younger than that in months, and I had to work when I couldn't work, and there wasn't any money. So it was less, well, during the war, of course, I got Winterball. A lot of countries failed, but actually, Europe.
I wouldn't go unless I would go first class all the way. And my husband's reached the point where he's counting the pennies. He never did. He has to count the pennies.
It doesn't cost all that much. And it doesn't. It doesn't cost much. Now, friends of mine in the Yucatan, I'm going back. I've been in South America for 15 years.
Let's read
today
about the motion.
Who's that? I can't go through. I mustn't go above 10,000 feet. At my age, unless they shoot for me, get blood clot. So I don't do that. I have. And Guatemala, for example. I know, though. I got so high it happens. So, you get life in Mexico City.
When I was young,
most
of the people. 7th grade, I read a book called I was fascinated about it. They were going to throw her off into the well, and that had gotten me interested. I had never seen a fine house. I don't know the
bring it up to me too.
Yes, Kyle.
It's a shame because I would be hunted up now if I could run.
Right.
But it's a child.
Good to see you.
I'm so glad to see you.
And you again.
I hope you do a lot more traveling.
Well, as long as I can.
Quickie for that little girl you were talking to.
Oh, hi. Well, of course.
We appreciate it.
I'll do it. Now, how do you want this signed? Put your name down here.
Read it, Sam Curry.
EDUS, I thought so. I've seen it many times. How many years?
A long time.
And CDRRA.
I just got through that recently, so I know what you're talking about. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Hey, see you all. You all retired.
Wonderful. Yes, it is.
Are you rocking in the rocking chair yet?
I've never had time to sit in.
But you told us you would.
I will. I hope you would.
Later.
Somebody told me. It's very comfortable. Other people say it. A lot of things last time.
You'll never stop. I know you. Well, sure is good to see you.
Nobody else does anything except us, so they shouldn't know. Anyway, we want to set up another date.
Okay.
just whenever you're free.
Well, I do have a dental appointment in February. Let me see. But I, because I'm leaving on the 20th, I can come right away. Right away. What about next week?
Well, let's see.
A week after next, because I'll be going away the 20th.
Could you do it on Tuesday,
either
week?
Yeah. Now let's see, what is today? Today's Monday. I could do an extra on the other Tuesday, whichever you like. I prefer Black Tuesday better. Monday would be better for me.
Well, that'd be fun.
No, let me go to Tuesday.
Yeah,
you like it?
Yeah,
fine.
Yeah, great. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.